Y'all see that? It's so pretty.
That's made me believe it. That's made me believe it. Believe you won't deceive me.
My beautiful worlds, to another video. And hi, if you're new, my name is Royalty, and today we're going to be getting into these brows first and foremost, and we're gonna be getting into this look right here. Do you guys see this? Can you see a flame? She did what had to be done. She really did. If you want to see the details of this look, my face included, then keep watching. For this step, you guys, you can just use a clear, not a clear, but any spoolie. It doesn't have to be one that's stained with concealer. You can just use any kind, but I'm using this because my eyes will soon be, my brows will soon be white anyways. So what I do with my brows is I use a light concealer. I'm using this color right here. You can use any light concealer, to be honest, it doesn't matter. I'm gonna brush it through my brows. Then I'm gonna take a little like blending brush like this, and I'm gonna setting the concealer with cream eyeshadow. I'm using this palette right here, and this is the color I'm using. You guys see, it matches the color of the concealer. It's not really white, it's like cream. So yeah, I'm just patting it on top of the concealer. Then I'm gonna brush through again. I repeat this. I do this twice. Go back and forth. And the last step is to brush through again with the remaining concealer. By the way, I don't add any more concealer to the brush when I'm working on one brow. That's why I do one brow at a time. So I don't add any more concealer. And that's it. I'm kidding, guys. You gotta, clean it up. I use a cotton swab. I've actually done a tutorial on my Instagram, but it wasn't very in-depth. You have to like, because it's very simple. You just look at what I'm doing. Got it. But you use the cotton swab and you just basically, it's like when you're cleaning up your concealer, and you're literally cleaning up your concealer. Like, look at how just clean that shape is. I'm gonna do the bottom so you guys can see it for real. But yeah, look at that shape. Like, using the cotton swab is like the best hack ever, because it literally gives you the exact shape you want. I've done this and I've made like, I'm gonna say 2-3 different shapes. This is like the insta brow shape. So you can really just clean up your concealer in whatever shape you want and get whatever shape you want. I'm actually really upset, you guys, because I usually use my cellular water for this next step, which is what I will recommend, but my cellular water literally disappeared. It's been missing for the past 3 days, so we're just gonna go with the next best thing, what I have in hand, Vaseline and a cotton pad. If you saw my first tutorial on Instagram, you know I use my cellular water, but she disappeared. So we're gonna use Vaseline to clean up like around the brows where we don't want. So you see where my brow actually is, and this white line on top of it, we're gonna clean it off. All right, so that's it. I'm going to move on to my eyes now. guys. I let my sister use this. I should hit her up, right? I should. Anyways, this is supposed to be a voiceover, but it's very simple. There's no need to do a voiceover. So this is from, I'm gonna put it on the screen because I actually do not remember, but it came in a pack. So yeah, I'm gonna use a little bit of water. My sister says not to use water at all, that it's better that way, but I don't believe her. But I'm using this small detail brush I got from Taylor Beauty, a black owned business. But you can get a brush like this, I think, from an arts and crafts store. But why do that when you can support a black business? You know what I'm saying? I'm gonna attempt to draw flames, y'all. If it doesn't work out, don't come for me. Working. Can y'all see? It's looking really bright on camera. Can y'all see though? Cute. Do y'all see that? It's so pretty. I'm gonna just fill it in a little bit, but yeah, it's really cute. So this is what we have. Oh my God, it's so cute. I love it. I'm gonna continue the other eye, the liner, but I'm not gonna like show y'all in detail because we just did this. Y'all, pray that I get the shape correctly. Like, let's just hope. This is like, I love it, you guys. Like, really? I just came and did what had to be done. I really did. I really did. Period. So I'm gonna move on to my face now. I'm starting off with the e.l.f. Prep and Hydrate Balm. If you saw my video where I was trying out that new foundation routine, you probably kind of know how this works. I actually don't prime often because usually when I do my makeup, I'm just sitting in the house. Because I don't really need my makeup to last or to do anything but just sit there. I've been using this sometimes. This e.l.f. This e.l.f. concealer. I bought it to use as a concealer, but it was too dark. And I figured it works pretty well as a corrector, even though it doesn't have an orange tone. It's more like my foundation color. So I use it around my lip area before I conceal. But today I'm doing it even before foundation. Hopefully that works. I'm going to be going in with my Milani foundation. This is their 2-in-1 foundation and concealer. I love it because it's medium coverage. This is in the shade 14A Coco. She looks great. Next, I'm going in with this e.l.f. Another e.l.f. concealer. I'm using this to highlight. This is their Hydrating Concealer in the shade D. guys, I actually like really like contouring my nose now. And cream contour is the goat. Sometimes I contour my face too, but I don't feel like it today. But you know, I do come through with the reverse contour. If you've been following me, you already know what that was. You already know what it was. I like to blend out my nose contour first, just so that when I blend out my concealer on my nose, I can stay within the dimensions. So for a more highlighted look, I'm gonna go in with a lighter concealer just to give me a more like lifted look. You guys can see just how much lifted this side of my face looks compared to this side. Granted, I haven't blended it out, but that's the point. Like, I want you guys to see how lifted, like, where my eye area is compared to that. So now I'm gonna set and fake. I'm using the Kween Cosmetics setting luxury powder. Now I'm gonna go in with my contour palette from Black Radiant. I'm gonna put it where I would have contoured, but it's like a bronzer. You guys see that? Just see the shape of my face has changed for the better. If this video is long, I apologize. I'm going to do it on my nose to add definition to my contour. Now I'm gonna bake not my whole face, because you guys know that's just not for me, but I'm gonna bake the points where I highlighted. My smile lines. If you have smile lines, I suggest you bake them. And to just make my reverse contour look better, I'm gonna set there also. So now I look like this. So now I'm gonna clean off the baking with my foundation brush. And this really helps so it doesn't leave any kind of cast. Especially if you're dark skin like I am, you don't want to leave any kind of cast. I don't like a very obvious cast. So I use my foundation brush to like kind of blend it away, and I'm like blending and sweeping it away. I'm gonna go with the same shade of purple I have. My lid. Actually, I'm gonna use a lighter one. Still so very good. So for my waterline, I went in with this NYX jumbo pencil and a small detail brush. Okay guys, this is the final look. Thank you guys so much for watching, for staying till the end. I appreciate it a whole lot. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to give it a thumbs up. Comment in the comment section if you if this brow tutorial was helpful for you, and if you'd like to see more from me or what else you'd like to see from me. Thank you guys so much for watching. I appreciate it a lot, and I'll see you guys in the next one. Bye.